in Baltimore. WBAL-TV 11 News continues.
Welcome back, and joining us now to answer your pet questions, Dr. Mike Herko with
Good morning.
A big guy.
Yeah, this is Mickey. She's one of the rabbits owned by one of our clients, hanging out with us today. And
just not your garden variety rabbit.
No.
What is this?
This is a big old rabbit here who actually would like the chefs that were on before to know we're off limits. No rabbits.
Is this a specific breed that grows large like this?
Or? Yeah, this is the actual breed. This is, you know, this is normal size for this rabbit. It's similar to one of the ones we had previously that came in, you know, humongous.
Yeah.
So this is normal size.
Do they, where are they native to?
Ooh.
Have I thrown you a curve?
Yeah,
there?
You threw me a little curve on that one. You know, I don't know specifically where these ones are, you know, coming from. But, you know,
Mickey's
this, like
not
I said,
overweight.
No, this is definitely not overweight. This is about what we're supposed to be.
Okay. We'll answer the curve question next week.
We'll get you on that one.
My two Dachshunds love to eat holly leaves. Boy, they're prickly. I wonder how they do that. Anyway, as soon as they run outside, they eat the leaves. That's what they look for. Is this safe?
No. Holly, you know, can be a little caustic. It can, you know, be toxic if they get enough of the berries more so than the leaves. So that's definitely not something you want to have them doing on a routine basis. You know, getting them away from there, putting a little fence around the holly bushes would probably be a better situation.
Okay. Good piece of information there. How can you care for your dog's teeth if he doesn't let you brush them? Are there treats or toys that can promote dental health, little chew toys or something like that?
A combination of both of those.
Uh-huh.
They actually have special diets that will do it. You know, TD diet, for example. There's a lot of different treats and stuff out there. The Nyla bones that, you know, you can use for them. So there's a variety of things that you can use. Now, if they'll let you brush their teeth, that's even better. But many dogs are iffy about that.
Can they be
idea.
Taught to tolerate it?
Yeah. I mean, if you start early, and we tell people with puppies and all, you know, you start messing with teeth and toes and ears, you know, at that age. And,
they
you
get
know, older
it.
On, they get used to it. Mm. And we're amenable to having that done.
So when you get a new puppy,
start
that. That's and the teeth are really a prime thing in dog's health.
And the vets and vet techs will appreciate it if you do that because it helps with the toenail trims and ear cleanings and stuff like that as well.
Okay, very good. My 4-year-old female cat is very aggressive. Is there any medication she can take to calm her down? A number of things come to mind.
Yeah. Not something you want to have on lifelong, though. You know, there's a couple different things that are going on, and part of it depends on, you know, what the aggression's coming from. So, I mean, that would be something to talk with a vet about. You know, there are behaviorists out there that, you know, we can hook you up with if necessary. And, then, yes, there are medications. There are animals that are on Prozac, for example, or Elavil, amitriptyline, things like that.
But that's something you like to try to work out a different solution first.
Yeah, you want to try to find out if there's a trigger for it first, you know, see if you can, you know, decrease that possibility or, you know, get rid of some of the other factors.
Okay.
But, yeah, definitely talk with your vet on that one.
Mike, thanks for joining us
Anytime.
This morning. We'll see you again next week. And don't